foie gras lovers, welcome to Urban Merchants. My name is Attila Josa and I'm cooking at home in my own garden. I'm not a chef, just a cook with passion for delicious and simple home cooked food. Today's recipe, whole roasted duck foie gras. I'm using fresh duck foie gras for this. Use a good quality, grade A, not frozen, must go for fresh. And I'm going to roast it with freshly grounded pepper, salt, espelette pepper. Espelette pepper is from the French region. It's not hot, but it has a nice warmth. It goes very well with foie gras, especially if you serve it with roasted figs with honey, roasted walnuts, and fig jam served over a nice loaf, sliced loaf of brioche. Now, for the roasting, I'm using hay in a big cake pan, if you like to call it cake pan. Another cake pan, which has holes on it. The purpose of this one, that is going to drip the fat through and is going to flavor the hay and ignite smoke. Now, I suggest to do this in the barbecue if you can. You might get a bit too much smoke in your home if you do it in the oven, but please be careful if you do it in your oven, the hay can catch a fire. That's why I suggest to use it in the barbecue. Here is my barbecue is ready, 200 degrees. We're gonna roast it for about 20 to 25 minutes. Okay, so here is our foie gras. I removed it from the package. Now, I suggest if the foie gras is too big, you can always remove and split it in two pieces. This is a smaller lobe, so I'm just going to use the whole lobe. So let's season up. Fresh pepper. Be generous. Don't be shy on this one. Good pinch of salt. And the lovely espelette. Again, this espelette has a good heat, but it's not too much. Be generous with espelette. It's gonna give you the flavor we were looking for. A good heat, but not too much. Now turn it around, tap it in a little bit. There we go. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Fresh pepper, good pinch of salt. It's all flavors. We need flavors here. And espelette. Just love this espelette. There you go. So our foie gras is seasoned. Just tap it all up, mop it up. Anything left on the plate, there's no waste here. Here you go. So we got the foie gras ready to go. Place it in the pan. This is a non-sticky pan. No oil, no fat, nothing. Remember, foie gras is 90% fat. That's why we need the high heat. Otherwise, the foie gras will melt away and you will end up with almost nothing on your pan. In goes the fig. Just going to split it a little bit. Just quarter it. Open it a bit. There you go. Place it next to the foie gras. Another one. If you're not comfortable with this, do it on a board. It's always safer. Be careful with sharp knives. There you go. Couple of figs. Another one, why not? Got it nice and ripe. Riper your figs, more flavor you get out of it. There we are. Now, a little bit of runny honey on the figs only. It helps, caramelizes. Always funny noise coming out from these tubes, isn't it? There you go. Ah, that looks lovely. And it will taste lovely. Now, ready for the oven. Here we are, 200 degrees. In your oven is the same 200 Celsius fan. In goes the foie gras. Here we go. We leave it there for 20, 25 minutes, but I will come back and check on that. Hello, see you later. So while my foie gras is roasting, I'm going to toast my walnuts. This is unsalted walnuts. Just a good handful, you know. Leave some whole, break some up. half, quarter, doesn't really matter. This is for the texture. And it gives you a nice contrast on the palate as well. Yeah. A few more. A few. Okay, close that. Let's check on our foie gras. Look at that. Nice and smoky. The hay is smoking around. Our figs are roasting nicely. And the foie gras as well. So easy to check. It should go very easily in. And you can test it on your lips. It's getting warm. As long as your lips can resist, then it's ready. This is not ready yet. It needs another 5 minutes. So our foie gras is ready. I just checked. So let's remove it from the oven. Gloves on. Don't try it without. It's an extremely hot pan. I won't risk it. It's quite dangerous. Make sure you have protection. That is, smells amazing. You can smell the hay. You can smell the roast foie gras. You can smell the figs, the honey. It's all gorgeous, I promise you. Now what we're going to do, because we are outdoors in the garden and a bit windy, we're going to rest it for 5 minutes. I'm going to cover it. I don't want it to get too cold. I want it to be lukewarm. This is not a hot, not a piping hot dish. It's a lukewarm dish, like almost like a pate. We're going to slice the bread in a minute, toast it, and then while this is rested, we're going to serve it. There you go, my foie gras resting. Very excited. Let's toast some brioche. I'm just going to do a couple of slices for now, but you can keep toasting for your friends. Oh, we're on the barbecue. Yeah, let's toast those ones nicely. Okay, let's plate up. Fig jam from Corsica, rustic, artisanal product. Just make a little nest. I have to be very pretty this one. I cannot do it pretty anyway. I'm home. Now comes foie gras. I'll try to lift this out delicately. Oh, look at that, look at that. That is heaven. Looks gorgeous. Delicious smell. Here comes my figs. Just place these your figs on the jam. It's jammy as well. It's roasted with the honey. It's nice and jammy. Here we are. That's it. There you have it. Foie gras on the plate. Well rested. You can tell it's not running away. Now, a little bit of the fish. Nicely. Toast, a couple of brioche, cut at an angle, just like your toast in the morning. Fire it up. There you go. There you have it. My whole roasted foie gras with espelette pepper, figs, and walnuts, which is coming up. Don't forget the walnuts. You need it for the crunch. And the toasted. Let's have it all. Enjoy that. Let's taste it. I can't wait. Need a bit of salt. You always need a bit of salt. Foie gras can handle a lot of salt. So here we go. Take your bread. Go in. Look at that. Smells. Foie gras. Yeah. Get a bit of fig jam. Bit of nuts on it. I like a bit of salt, but you do it as you wish. There you go. Excellent. Delicious. Good heat, good sweetness. You really get that smoky flavor from the barbecue and the hay, which is very important in this case for this recipe. There you go, that's a delicious dish to try with your friends, and thank you for watching today. All the key ingredients available on our website, www.urbanmerchants.co.uk. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Facebook for upcoming recipes. Thank you again, bye bye, see you soon.